The conflict of reason versus mysticism is the issue of life or death, of freedom or slavery, of progress or stagnant brutality. Let us define our terms. What is reason? Reason is the faculty which perceives, identifies, and integrates the material provided by man's senses. Reason integrates man's perceptions by means of forming abstractions or conceptions, thus raising man's knowledge from the perceptual level, which he shares with animals, to the conceptual level, which he alone can reach. The method which reason employs in this process is logic. And logic is the art of non-contradictory identification. What is mysticism? Mysticism is the acceptance of allegations without evidence or proof, either apart from or against the evidence of one's senses and one's reason. Mysticism is the claim to some non-sensory, non-rational, non-definable, non-identifiable means of knowledge, such as instinct, intuition, revelation, or any form of just knowing. Reason is the perception of reality and rests on a single axiom, the law of identity. Mysticism is the claim to the perception of some other reality, other than the one in which we live, whose definition is only that it is not natural, it is supernatural, and is to be perceived by some form of unnatural or supernatural means. In Western civilization, the period ruled by mysticism is known as the Dark Ages and the Middle Ages. I will assume that you know the nature of that period and the state of human existence in those ages. The Renaissance broke the rule of the mystics. Renaissance means rebirth. I have said that faith and force are corollaries and that mysticism will always lead to the rule of brutality. The cause of it is contained in the very nature of mysticism. Reason is the only objective means of communication and of understanding among men. When men deal with one another by means of reason, reality is their objective standard and frame of reference. But when men claim to possess supernatural means of knowledge, no persuasion, communication, or understanding are possible. Why do we kill wild animals in the jungle? Because no other way of dealing with them is open to us. And that is the state to which mysticism reduces mankind. A state where, in case of disagreement, men have no recourse except to physical violence. And more, no man or mystical elite can hold the whole society subjugated to their arbitrary assertions, edicts, and whims, without the use of force. Anyone who resorts to the formula, "It's so because I say so," we'll have to reach for a gun sooner or later.